Well, what fantastic scenes we've got here at Leichhardt Oval, as Peter and Phil have rightly described, with Andrew's help and people sitting on the balconies of adjoining houses, takes me back to a midweek cup final back in when was it? 1981.
Record.
South Sydney and Cronulla Sutherland. A massive crowd that night. It's been eclipsed since then in 2005 by these two sides, South Sydney and the West Tigers. 22,877 is the ground record for Leichhardt as the red and green go out in quest of a finals series position for the first time since 1989, when they were the minor premiers but lost 32-16 in the preliminary final to Canberra. A dream, a chance to be realised here for the mighty club from Redfern. They've won more premierships than any other club. And now the Tigers, they've put on a real day here. They've brought out all the old warriors from western suburbs and from Balmain. Fireworks going off from the top of the old grandstand. Robbie Farrer, of course, leading the Dally M Player of the Year when voting went secret. Will he be the Player of the Year? Benji Marshall starting to find the electrifying form that has made him one of rugby league superstars. They've won 10 of their last 12 games at Leichhardt. It's an awesome record. They've won their last four matches against South Sydney, and three of those have been at Leichhardt. Tony Archer's the referee. The Tigers have lost three of their four under the control of Archer. South this year have only played under him once, and they lost that as well. Sunday afternoon football, the way it used to be. Possibly a ground record crowd to watch South Sydney do battle with western suburbs Balmain United. Here's Todd Payton with the first handle of the game and brought down just outside the 20-metre line. Farrah goes across, and Hyington, who's got a very good try-scoring record in recent times against South Sydney. Farrah thinks he's got markers, not direct. He didn't get the penalty he was looking for. And they're just outside their own 30-metre line. Play back to Brett Hodgson. And then it's away to Galloway, the red-headed prop forward from West Tigers. And played again back to Farrah before going on to Galea in 17. Locking the scrum in the opening part of the game. Just looking across the line. It's gone to Marshall. Just trying to work out where Fatawira is playing in relation to Lawrence. There was a thought that the youngster might come into 5-8 and Fatawira would go to the centres. They're 15 out from the south line as the red and green get their first touch of the ball.
Well, Ray, we've had a tip that will be the case in defence, that Lawrence will come three in. He's a good strong defender, as we see some strong defence there from his teammates. But those statistics you mentioned, it is all different now. This is a different South Sydney. This is a side that at this stage of the season...
Trouble for Nathan Merritt, Pete.
Yeah, he's still down getting attention.
So the Rabbits, with a bit of trouble with Nathan Merritt, one of their real impact players, with what looks like a knee injury in back play. Trainers with him. Played by John Sutton on the eastern side, the hillside of the ground. Back then for Joey Williams. He puts the kick away. It bounces awkwardly for Brett Hodgson. And Hodgson comes 25 metres away from his line, linking up with Chuaki.
He doesn't look happy, Merritt. They've left him out there. They've been signalled he's going to play on. There's a big hit for you. But Nathan Merritt is really struggling at the back here. And if he'll leave the field, that would change the complexion of this game completely.
Well, no wonder he's limping after that leg got caught under the tackler as Hyington straightens just shy of halfway. He's moving a touch more freely now at the back.
So the Tigers attacking. They plated the ball, the Rabbits, and it's probably play on. No, he's ruled knock-ons. Talanoa plated the football for South. I'm still not quite sure that West Tigers should not have been allowed an advantage. Well, here's Talanoa.
It was nice play, a little short interchange of passing, created an opportunity out wide. They risked it. Talanoa went for the ball. Collis couldn't get a handle on it. Probably should have been play on, but there was enough ricochets for the referee to say, well, we'll start with a scrum. The crowd is up. Have a look at this. The Tiger chant already. Only 1 minute into the game. And the players out there will not be able to hear themselves think, let alone talk to each other. This is awesome.
Marshall coming down the short side, linking with Hyington. Three tries in his last two games against the Rabbits. And a penalty goes to the home side.
Merritt's gone. Merritt's over here on the sideline signalling. He can't get himself back into the play. There's no replacement. He's now on the wing. There's no fullback.
So Merritt is guarding on the left side for Souths. And another penalty.
Strip the ball.
Stripping the ball.
Yeah, mate. Hang on.
So Galloway makes a charge at the line. Tries to spin across it. Got it away to Farrah. It goes away. There's a try on. It has gone forward. Payton dived over. Applauded himself and the crowd, but it's gone forward. Merritt is off.
Oh, what a blow for South Sydney.
But not when you're just slowing it up.
One of the real success stories. That pass from Ben Gallier to Todd Payton. Real to be forward. And again, the referee was in a good position to call on that. Wonderful offload from Keith Galloway with defenders hanging off him. Merritt up the race.
Match going into the UK and, of course, across to New Zealand, up to Papua New Guinea. And for the first time in my memory, going into Hollywood. Live, albeit into, I guess, a hotel room on Sunset Boulevard. Russell Crowe getting exclusive pictures over there in Hollywood. And I trust you have a good afternoon watching it, Russ, or a good night, but you've lost Nathan Merritt. Asatasi, 32 metres away from his own line up the middle. Shane Rigon gives it left. It goes to Williams to the 40. He got it to Dean Winters. Winters is inside the 30. And Benji Marshall rounds him up from behind. South on the attack on 5. South Sydney with Gordon. Williams. Williams away to a falling Jeremy Smith. He puts it over the head of Tuaki. A bat down and then a knock on. Advantage applies. Tigers ball. Lawrence is with it.
Oh, outstanding football. Dean Winters had plenty of support inside and out, but he wouldn't have been able to hear them. Wonderful ball from Joey Williams. Winters on the field to replace Merritt. Players looming up. He wouldn't have heard them. Pinned the ears back when himself and Marshall made the tackle.
Shuaki now playing it on the eastern side of the ground. Beautiful day in Sydney. Just a thin cloud cover, very high. As Farrah goes behind Galloway to Hodgson, and then Hodgson away, finding Galea. Galea taking the smaller players with him. In fact, Rogers, the 13, who was their regular 5-8s. And then a kick by Marshall, and an awkward one for Gordon, the number 4 for the Rabbits, but he cleaned it up.
He got a deflection there. It was a fairly fortunate one, because Benji Marshall was looking to kick him deliberately for his outside men. 6 minutes of missed opportunity so far. An unmarked Todd Payton. Failed to score. Forward pass. And Ben Rogers loomed up on the inside of Dean Winters. Couldn't be found. As Asatasi takes it to the 40.
It looks like Winters has gone to centre. Gordon has gone to the wing. And Talanoa, the number 2, has dropped back to fullback. That's the changes in the back line to accommodate the loss of Nathan Merritt, who was crunched in his first tackle of the game.
The long go. Played the ball. Williams puts a kick in the air. And it came down for Gordon. But I think the Tigers have got it. They have. Tigers football through Collis, and now it's Galea who runs it away and runs it infield accordingly. 22 metres out from their own line, and Hyington going up the middle with a run of about 10, 12 metres, and the Rabbitohs meet him and hold him. Hyington playing it for Farrah, who's going down the short side, and he's caught them offside, he's caught them not direct. Yes, it's the direct ruling that he's got the markers for. Farrah was awake to that. He tried for it earlier.
He's clever. He just has a look and makes sure that he goes if the markers aren't set. That's the second or third time this afternoon. He looks up, sees that they're not in the right position, and he demands a penalty from the referee with that run.
So Galloway running up, and making himself a fairly easy target for South Sydney. And Farrer sends Payton now inside the 30. Marshall, Jinx, goes off his left foot a couple of times, but then Folongo goes in over the top to put him away. Played by Marshall, Farrer goes to Hodgson. Hodgson gets it away to Fulton. It's on the ground, advantage for South for Rigon. And Rigon 25 away from his own line. The team that beat Manly on Monday, giving them a massive start and coming back with 18 unanswered points in the second half. Paul Mellor pulled down 5 metres short of halfway, playing it back to Nigel Vanganar. Vanganar tries to burrow across that halfway line. He's held by Fulton. Now it comes away from Jeremy Smith, away for Roy Asatasi. And Asatasi's 38 metres out from the line on 5. Back now for Williams again, and a similar kick. Over it goes towards the right side for the Tigers, and it's been taken by Williams, given under Cusack on the ground. It waits there for Jeremy Smith, and Williams again get a bat off the ground. And South Sydney on the attack now. Played by Folongo, it's gone quickly through the hands. It's out to Vanganar. Nigel Vanganar, close to the line, held up.
Brilliant commentary, Rebs. I don't know how you keep up with it. It's all over the place here. Exciting stuff. Williams bombing Marshall, as predicted. The Tigers attacking the right-hand side of the field, as predicted. South Sydney on the attack. Tackles up their sleeve.
So the ball comes away to Folongo, and he gets it away, and Asatasi can't get a touch on it. Penalty goes, though. Held without the football. Fitzhenry the offender, and Asatasi the victim.
Well, I reckon he knew that his teammate here was held back and threw the pass. The pass wasn't on, but he was aware that Fitzhenry had hold of his man. An interesting decision. They're going to go for the try.
Cusack then. 8 metres out from the West Tigers line. Down at the river end of the ground. It's with Williams, who loses his footing.
He'll be upset with his outside man there, Dean Witters, who overran him. He needed him deep if he was going to go second. Here is Witters out of dummy half, centre field.
Sandwiched in the tackle of Hyington and Galloway. Now it's gone from Regan. It's gone wide out there for Smith, and knocked on by Folongo, advantage. Goes West Tigers. Ball fallen on by Todd Payton. Now Lawrence, the young winger centre, maybe 5/8 today. Galloway then with a surge. That line is the 30-metre line just in front of him. Then for Marshall. Now for Galea. And Galea taken over the top there by Rogers and underneath by Widders. Marshall to Payton now as they drive the football up towards the halfway line. The home side West Tigers, who've piled on massive defeats against South Sydney in their 2 meetings last year. Statistics that probably mean nothing given the new personnel that arrived at Redfern this year. That is Talanoa losing the ball. We'll take a break and come back and see what happens next in just a moment. Sunday football on 9, second last weekend of the regular competition, and when we went to the break, it was Talanoa losing the ball, knocking on, and a scrum, loose head and feed for the Tigers inside the 20-metre line. Marshall, or Hodgson fed the ball. Marshall stood out. He goes to Collis, who tries to stay in the field of play. He flicks it in. There's a race for the ball. Kicked by Hodgson. Hits South Sydney. Bounce back favourably for Marshall. Marshall gets it away. This is Fulton. Fulton comes to the defence. Doesn't quite know where to go. He knew not to run behind Hyington, though. Farrer then goes behind the decoy. Picks up Galea. And he's driven by Asatasi and Rogers. Played back for Farrer. To the right for Hyington, then for Farrer. And Farrer's 3 metres away from the line in front of the grandstand end of Leichhardt Oval. A slow play the ball, and then Hodgson. Now they bullet the pass along the line. Mellor to clean up. Mellor, will he get it back? The big fellow will. Paul Mellor, who debuted in 1991. And still getting the job done. Here's Talanoa. He's very fast. There's a foot race on. He passes the ball. Jeremy Smith is with it now. He's not held. He gets up. He gets back to the 20-metre line. And Galloway is there with Lawrence and Hyington to pull him down.
Ah, football.
Vangana. Now for Williams. Then for John Sutton. Sutton tackle 10 away and a penalty Rabbitohs.
Now, they declined the points last time they were offered down here, and that was an easier attempt than this. The Tigers did the same in the first couple of minutes. The mentality is still the same. We're going for more.
Well, they obviously think they need to score tries to win. I know that's an understatement, but particularly against the Tigers, they'll be thinking the Tigers have got plenty of points in them, so penalty goals isn't going to win it.
Falongo.
Come on.
Taking it. First play. Rigon. Back into the middle for Cusack. And he's a metre from the line. Hodgson hangs in there with Payton. Rigon again runs back to find Williams, to find Falongo, to go away to Williams again. There's a chance here. Sutton goes over. John Sutton, the number 11, who was injured early in the year at Suncorp Stadium, gets the first try, the first points of the game.
He adds a new dimension to their attack, John Sutton, but have a look at the smart work here from Joe Williams. It came on the back of a big bust. Talanoa out of dummy half, straight through Lawrence. And he found support on his inside, probably a slower man in Jeremy Smith. He was knocked over, but it got South Sydney to the right end of the field. They received a penalty. And then this opportunity, Joe Williams. He goes to the man on the outside, stays alive. Now look at this bullet pass. Deliberately to get to the outside of Chris Lawrence, which he does, and John Sutton. It was 3-on-1 with that bullet pass. Sutton threw the dummy, kept the winger out of the play.
When this kid, Joe Williams, came from Wagga as a 15-year-old, he came to the Roosters. We used to bring him up once a month to train with the first grade side. At 15 years of age, he could fill in as a halfback for the first grade side and run all the plays. There's John Sutton, the try scorer. He's been up and down since then, Joey Williams. He was a player I always thought had great potential. He's starting to find his feet. He's had a couple of disappointments, but he's without a club, without a contract.
He'll be a star in France next year, Gus. That's
well,
where he's heading.
He doesn't need to go there. He's good enough to stay here in the NRL if someone just shows confidence in him.
Joe Williams, 10 in from touch, it's looking okay. Skims the inside edge of the paintwork. It is 6-0 South Sydney over the West Tigers. So our network's taking us live. Sunday afternoon version of our game. The way a lot of people love it. So welcome back to Sunday football from Leichhardt in front of a massive crowd. A sellout game, sold out as early as Wednesday of this week. And South Sydney have taken first blood. They've taken another major step towards making their first finals since 1989. Results in other matches, of course, governing the situation very much so. But a win for a team here today will take them 90% of the way, you would think, towards the top eight. Gordon is wrestled down. The arm got up around the neck, but Archer has said play on. Andrew Voss sideline.
Well, bad news for South Sydney. Nathan Merritt confirmed won't be back today. At this stage, they're saying a strained ligament rather than any tear. Scans tomorrow. Could open the door for David Peachy to come back. This is how it happened earlier in the match for Nathan Merritt. For Tuli Talanoa to play fullback the rest of today.
Galloway there. Taking it up towards the 20-metre line. South Sydney's defence so far has frustrated the West Tigers. Marshall around the back, a second manner for Fatawira. And Fatawira plays the ball 10 metres out from the line. It's come to Marshall, gone to Hodgson. Hodgson turns it, shows it, then goes himself. He's pulled down 8 metres away. Some concern over Farah, apparently. Galea goes away to Collis. He flicks it out the back for Fitzhenry. Then it goes back, and it's come down to John Morris. Morris stammers, then goes along looking for Hodgson and takes the tackle 9 out.
Robbie Farah's gone off. John Morris playing the football has gone to the dummy half role as Hodgson. kicks back to this side.
And the winger Fitzhenry is beaten by the flight. So it's gone out on the full and taken back to the 20. Robbie Farrer's off, and Andrew's got a report from the sideline.
Yeah, after the try was scored, after John Sutton went over, the trainer went straight to him in the in-goal area. Basically, I think it was left up to Robbie, and Robbie's come from the field. So this is, you know, tit for tat. South Luton, Nathan Merritt, key man at the back. I have to think, though, for the Tigers, no disrespect to Nathan, Robbie Farrer is such a part, such a vital cog of this Tigers side. Massive loss if he doesn't return.
Well, we were talking to assistant coach Roy Simmons before the game, and he was saying the injury was probably sorer this week than what it was going into last weekend. And that hip problem, they are so painful. The only way to get over them is complete rest, but they don't have that luxury at the moment.
Peter Royce was saying that's why Morris was left on the bench. They were a little worried he wouldn't get through this game, and if he felt any pain, they're worried about backing up next Friday night. So Morris was put on the sideline to come into the hooking role.
Ball played then by Asatasi, with South Sydney leading by 6-0 after 18 minutes. Luke Stewart is on for the Rabbitohs, and the penalty has gone against the West Tigers.
See, come this time of year, you've got to be prepared for thunderbolts. Things go wrong that you've got no way of controlling. Nathan Merritt, in the first minute of play, goes down for South Sydney. They've got to reshuffle. Robbie Farrer carrying injury, such an important part of their side. You've got to get over it. Get beyond the disappointment and carry on with the game.
So Rigon takes the tap. Andrew's got some more news. We'll go to him in a moment. Folongo is tackled 22 metres out towards middle ground. And then Rigon finding Asatasi, and Asatasi running with the enthusiasm that you would expect from him in a game like this. That pass is bad. Williams makes it look better. Scoops it up for Rogers. Rogers stands and gives it to Winters and puts another phase together for South Sydney. But he's knocked over on the 10-metre line as South Sydney attack the river end, and Winters a little bit slow to rise. Rogers in 13, 6 is Williams, and 16 is Stewart with the ball underneath three West Tigers defenders, including John Morris, who's on. Williams goes away with that pass to Smith. He'll score the number 7. Jeremy Smith puts it behind the black dot at the northern end of the ground.
He might have number 7 on his back, but he's played most of second receiver this afternoon. He's a favourite player of Jason Taylor, who took him across from Parramatta last season to South Sydney. As a dejected bench led by Robbie Farrell looks on, and Jeremy Smith, he's done it all himself here. He straightened the play beautifully and then showed good footwork. Beats 1, 2. The third one he beats allowed him to take it round to turn 4 into 6 from the conversion under the pace. Watch the step here and straighten. Beautiful stuff.
It's my favourite play for a 5-8, to catch the ball going sideways on what we call an out ball. Get the ball thrown spiralling out in front of you. You run onto it and the defence slides with you. And then at the moment they start to slide with you and you touch the ball, straighten up off your leg. They can't counter. And then you've only got one man to beat, which is the man coming from the inside. On that occasion, they were too slow. And Smith, with a beautiful right foot step, has pulled their pants down. Rabbitohs scored a try.
Maximus over in Holly would be smiling now. He lost Merritt, but he's got 2 tries. There's a converted try. We'll take a break, back in a moment. Sunday football on 9. Back to an excited South Sydney crowd, surely outnumbered by the black, white and gold of the Tigers. Galloway comes off, but South Sydney, their fans at the moment rejoicing at a 2 converted try lead, 12 points to nil in favour of South Sydney.
And one of the aims that South Sydney would have had coming here this afternoon was to keep the crowd out of this contest. Putting on 2 converted tries in pretty quick succession has done that. Jeremy Smith, a little bit of a push and throw from Bronson Harrison there.
This is Luke Stewart then with the ball, taken down by John Morris, and Bronson Harrison, mentioned by Peter, in 16, is out there now, took the place of Galloway. The 18 is out there as well. His name is Safi, Jared Safi, in the 18 shirt. South Sydney, 8 metres away from the halfway line. And as I said earlier, their defence, I know they've scored two tries, but their defence has turned the Tigers into a frustrated side. Marshall takes it outside 30 before finding Hodgson. Now the winger came in. There's space down there for Fatawira, or there was, and then a cross in cover when Jeremy Smith. Just inside the eastern touchline. Tigers with Tuaki up towards 30. He will play the ball there.
Oh, it's a good run. Pure perseverance.
Rugby League's one community this week, Young Care. And Young Care's mission is to provide dignified and relevant lifestyles for young people with high care needs. And so the Tigers, they continue on. And it is with Harrison who backs into them and then huddles over like a union forward. Morris away to Marshall. Oh, and it's been intercepted. It had to be by Gordon. He misses that and they're over.
Well, they keep coming down the right-hand side. That's where they want to attack. Gordon's done a good job, albeit he looks a little shaky. There seems to be points on offer, but at the moment the Tigers just can't get it to stick. You're talking about the crowd, Peter. I think South Sydney have beaten the crowd. There's only one man the crowd can influence now. That's the referee. He's going to have to be really strong with the home team behind and the crowd on his case.
Stewart rolled over onto his back. There's the man they're talking about, or Gus is. Tony Archer, Andrew Voss on the sideline. An update on the injuries.
Yeah, absolutely. Isaac Luke, first of all, on for South Sydney. Shane Rigg on off. Now, Robbie Farah, Serlo said it's a painful injury, the hip injury. It's actually what he's not feeling. He's lost feeling in the leg. Now, I don't know. Maybe in the aftermath of the match we're going to find out what happened, but it's almost shade to the 75 grand final with Changa Langlands. Robbie Farah, we know he's getting painkillers, but he's lost feeling in his leg.
I'm wondering, could it be a needle that's gone wrong? That's happened before. Greenfield is on.
Yeah, Greenfield on for Falongo.
Here's Hyington there.
Well, I guess that's what Voss is implying, because that's what happened with Graham Langlands, apparently, with the needle deadening his leg way back then. Keep an eye on Farah, because he's just sitting there looking like he's ready to go and trying to hit that hip to get something into it.
Safi short of halfway. Fitzhenry a run from dummy half, and the big forwards at markers one and two struggle for a moment to get to him, particularly Stewart. Greenfield made the tackle, the fair-headed 17. Hodgson turning it in for Harrison. He loses the ball and the Rabbits come away again with Isaac Luke. Luke allowed now to get up and play the ball by John Morris, who dominated in defence. And South Sydney totally in the ascendancy at the moment. Play by Talanoa. John Sutton, who got one of the two tries. Jeremy Smith got the other. And they're near the halfway line, the Rabbitohs. Vunganar away for Greenfield, and Greenfield tries to chop his way through. So he's on the 40-metre line, playing it in the middle of the ground. Luke away for Williams. Williams on for Rogers, looking to turn it round the corner. And he's tackled on the 30-metre line, West Tigers end of the ground. Williams again gets a short ball away to Stewart. And he runs into Safi and Morris on the 20-metre line. Playing it back for Luke and then Williams. And Williams puts a kick back onto the short side. Looking for Gordon. That might be a mid-air tackle. It is. It's a penalty for tackling a defender in mid-air. It's a relief for the Tigers. They're being outgunned across the park.
That's a good decision there. He was very high, Daniel Fitzhenry, when he was claimed. Not a lot of relief, because they won't find a lot of ground with this kick. It'll be 10 metres. He's getting some good energy off his bench, Jason Taylor. Luke Stewart always very strong. I like young Greenfield. He's a good talent. He's involved in that tackle there. And Isaac Luke, but we know how dangerous he is out of dummy half.
Morris for Galea to go ahead. Taking the ball 35 metres out from the line. Morris now for Hyington as they pump away down the South Sydney left side.
They've been coming there all day, haven't they? They love it down here.
Work being carried out there. One of the players off the bench, I think it's Roy Asatasi, isn't it? Yeah, Asatasi having some tension relief there from maybe a hamstring, a niggling hamstring or something like that. Bronson Harrison, 42 metres away from the South Sydney line. And then Hodgson finds himself a dummy half, and then Marshall puts a kick in. and Gordon hangs a hand out, goes behind him. Now he tries to get it back. He'll do that easily. Out to the 10-metre line, and he comes into a shoulder then from Fulton. So here's Mellor, the big winger, going in, running from dummy half, out to the 20-metre line, and a penalty to South Sydney.
Well, that makes it four apiece, but the ones that the West Tigers are giving away are making it much easier for the current leaders in this game. Over the top there, Bronson Harrison. There's points in this West Tigers. You can look at them and see the points there. It's just whether they've got the patience not to get frustrated and the ability to just put it all together to take advantage of the pressure when they get down there.
Stewart tackled just outside 40-metre line. Play back to Luke. Now Cusack. And Cusack runs into Harrison and Safi. And they're just outside the 30-metre line. They're going onto the attack again. Luke! Hanging onto the ball and looking to go himself was brought down by Safi. Williams. Williams up to the 10 and gets it back to Widders. Dean Widders, who made a wonderful break early in the game. Here's Gordon with a fend and a surge and a jump. And he's over. Gordon has scored for the Rabbitohs. Three tries for the afternoon, sending them out to a lead of 16-0.
Well, this is the young man that is keeping the very experienced Shannon Hegarty in Premier League at the moment. He looks as fit as I've seen him in his short time in first grade. And like Jeremy Smith in his try, he's done it all himself. Gets out of dummy half. He's a tall man, strong, through some smaller defenders and crashes over.
Well, he's been targeted all day. The Tigers have been running all their attack at Yulin Gordon. He just stood his ground. He's fielded kicks, he's made tackles, and now he comes back with a little bit of his own. Get out of my way, spin, in he goes. South Sydney are on fire at the moment. It's not over. It is not over. But you can't do any more than they've done in the first 30 minutes of this game. They have quietened this big crowd. They've come to the Tigers' den, and they're sticking it to them.
And there he is, Yulin Gordon. What a game he's having. He's grabbed every vantage point, haven't they? Some flares being lit up on the hill. This is a fairly dangerous pastime in a crowd as big as this. Williams, 19 in from touch, 18 metres out, kicking to the river end. Having a fine game, Joey Williams. Hits it sweetly. Another two on the board. 18-0. South Sydney over West Tigers in 9 Sunday football.
Let's stay behind.
Back on Sunday football, and it is a shock scoreboard to those that may have just joined us, and I guess most of the pundits. 18-0 in favour of the Rabbitohs. They're getting the job done beautifully at the moment.
Well, it isn't as though the Tigers haven't been here before. Let's go back to last weekend. 18-4 down at half-time against the Cronulla Sharks. It's good ground again made out of dummy half. But within the space of 7 minutes second half, in fact 10 minutes into the second half, they found themselves in front of the Tigers. So South Sydney know that a lot of hard work to be done in the next 50 minutes.
Greenfield tackled back on his 40-metre line. 10 from 15 completions for the Tigers, 13 from 17 for South Sydney. So here they go to Sutton, down the right side, draws them, finds Vungada, and Nigel Vungada scores. Try number four for the Rabbitohs. Well, the scoreboard attendant can hardly keep up at the moment.
I'm not quite sure why we're going upstairs, but I love a player with vision. I love a man who can make a split-second decision, make it the right one in the circumstances he is faced by. This is Bungana scoring the try. I'm assuming... Oh, gee.
He's dropped it.
Oh, no.
He has dropped it.
Now, the man I'm talking about with the vision is Jeremy Smith, deciding to run the football instead of passing.
He's dropped it.
But Nigel Vungana, a prolific try scorer over a long period of time, may have done a Max Mannix.
Oh.
And bombed a certainty.
It has come loose from his grip. And the man with the vision is the one that's picked that up, because everyone was just standing and cheering. Can you believe it? This could be a massive turning point in the game.
Oh. Mario sitting alongside Craig Coleman, their heads go down in unison.
He fell off the seat, Mario.
Unbelievable.
That decision there from Jeremy Smith, he was going to kick, it was the last. But he read the situation, he read that they had an opportunity, put Sutton through, who put Bunganar through, who bombed it at the death. Morris out of dummy half.
Well, Tony Archer was right there. He was the one that put the whistle to his mouth and called for the video referee. There is nowhere to hide in rugby league anymore. They got cameras everywhere.
FitzHenry up to the 40-metre line. And then lofted across from Morris. It's in the centre of the ground with the 17. That's Ben Galea. Five gone for the Tigers. Have they been given a confidence boost by something that you'd never expect from Nigel Wanganaa with the experience he's got? Mellor brings it back again for the Rabbitohs. Almost out to the 20-metre line.
Strange thing is, Ray, that he did the right thing in going down, looking to press it with the body. It's not as though he tried to place the football down and lost his grasp on it. He actually got down the way that I think most coaches want their players to score a try, to make a bird of it. And somehow it slipped out.
I don't want to be the next Tigers player that runs at him, though. I think he'll be looking to make up for it.
Cusack playing it on the 30-metre line. Williams boots it down the ground. It bounces up high the first time and the second time before Hodgson gets some hands on it. Wanganaa dropping the ball. And there's his reaction when he sees no try. I don't quite know why, that it came unexpected to him. He's got all the ticks in the boxes. He's got all the stripes, Nigel Wanganaa. You don't expect him to do that. Missed tackles, West Tigers 13, South Sydney 3. Lawrence for Payton. Time in possession, 56% of it going to South Sydney. Hodgson to Morris, Morris to Marshall. Marshall away for Teo. Teo is held and gets it away before it hits the ground. Intercepted by Luke. And he's intercepted by Marshall. 28 away from the South Sydney line. It is with Talaneo, who I should mention was sent back to fullback with the unfortunate loss of Nathan Merritt in the opening couple of minutes. And the penalty goes against the West Tigers defenders, interfering with the man tackled in his endeavours to get up and play the ball. Hyington on camera, the offender.
What do you think, Peter, about an early field goal in this game? 18 points to nil, 19 would be a massive lead, or does that signal maybe we're sick of, you know, we're finished with scoring tries and invite the opposition back? When is it too early to take a field goal?
No, take one any time now, especially coming up to halftime. If the opposition go in knowing that in normal time they've got to score more than three converted tries to be in front, I think psychologically it's a good blow to land as Stewart takes him inside. I'll feel as though there's more on offer as the ball comes back to Isaac Luke. All going South Sydney's way at the moment. Bar and Nigel Wanganaa knock on.
John Morris went in there with the express purpose of raking it, and he did that, but the ball went direct to the Rabbitohs support player. Here's Smith across the ground. Sutton is giving them an awful time out on the right side. He's got one try, and he sent Wanganaa in for what should have been a try. It's from Jeremy Smith now to Williams to Greenfield. Oh, Greenfield missed Teo just as well he did. Teo was like a missile. Here's Williams holding it back, and it's off Rogers and taken by Marshall.
There's real no advantage here. Joey Williams should have passed earlier. I think the cutout pass was on. He tried to play it too cute and go with the short ball. He feigned long and went short. Look at this. I think if he gives the ball now to Witters, Witters had a play on it. But Rogers got in front of him. He ended up having to give it to him, and it all went awry.
Short.
They're looking dangerous today, Robert, South.
The team that has got
a great defensive record, but when you talk about South in the lead up to this, you talk about their inability to score tries. And there's the defensive records of the two Souths ranked at number three. But in fact, scoring points has been their problem, but not today. Not when it matters.
They are ranked at number three, only behind Manly and Melbourne, but they are the worst attacking side statistically. They've scored less points than anybody else coming into this weekend.
Hodgson crosses halfway and decides to have a go himself.
But don't they defend well?
Greenfield, the man that tackled Hodgson. Morris crosses 40, runs and passes at the line before getting to Collis. The ball on the ground and Souths again, cleaning up.
Now, Daniel Fitzhenry needed to be outside Dean Collis there. He was lazy. It was the last tackle. He didn't think he was going to get involved in the play. And Collis opened up a corridor on the outside, but Daniel Fitzhenry was back 15 metres behind the play. Just have a look at this. He's looking for him. He wants him there in the first case, and the number two was too late.
He was further back than Walla Walla, wasn't he? South Sydney. Up towards halfway now. Andrew, sideline.
Yeah, Rabs, a couple of stats to keep in mind as we come up to halftime. South Sydney kept Manly scoreless second half last week. Have kept the Tigers scoreless first half today. So that's a great wrap for them. As Smith tries that little kick, doesn't get it back. Tigers will come up with the ball. But on the Tigers, talking up their hopes. Last week, halftime against the Sharks, they were down 18 points to 4 at halftime. Within 13 minutes of the second half getting underway, they were in front. Comeback not out of the question for the Tigers.
Marshall pushing it on the bounce for Collis, and now Fitzhenry is there where he should have been about 1 minute ago. And Daniel Fitzhenry to play the ball. 2 minutes exactly to the halftime break, and Tim Sheens can't get them in there quick enough. Collis, 20 in from touch. 7 metres his own side of halfway. Morris for Payton. Payton taken beautifully by Widders. Low man first and the high man second, Greenfield. Then for Marshall. Marshall thrusting it back for Hodgson. Comes to Greenfield and Hodgson loses the ball. Widders gets it away. Luke gives it on. It's with Rogers. Rogers is tackled and put away by Collis.
Trying too hard, aren't they? Just trying too hard. Can't quite get the right pass to stick. It's worrying. The scoreboard is now in their head. Next Friday night, Cowboys and Bulldogs. The Dogs are going to need a win if they want a home semi-final or any chance of it.
John Sutton on the halfway line, centre ground. Luke and then Smith now for Greenfield. He stands and provides for Vanganar. And Vanganar is tackled inside the 40-metre line. So under a minute of the first half to go. Fabulous day set up by the West Tigers here at Leichhardt. Jason Taylor, the coach of South Sydney, he and his team members have so far spoiled the party. Luke puts a kick in. It's inside the 20 and wobbling around, and Gordon couldn't get to it. Marshall got a couple of kicks on it. What a pickup! What a pickup by Marshall! Gordon chases, and so does Stewart. How does he get down there? Marshall gets away, gets it onto Fitzhenry. Fitzhenry scores. Fitzhenry, he scores. He goes from villain to hero in 5 minutes.
Well, we're going to go back and have a look at the start of it.
And the onside.
But last weekend, Andrew Voss was just talking about, I mentioned it earlier, the comeback. It was led by Benji Marshall against the Sharks, racing 80 metres on a loose ball to score. What about the effort of that man, Luke Stewart? I thought it was a centre three-quarter coming. No knock on there. That's what I think will be the main concern in going to the video referee. Daniel Fitzhenry going over the top of the football. Benji Marshall keeps it on the toe. Now Fitzhenry is in front of him. Keeps kicking the football. Keeps kicking the football. Fitzhenry's fine now. Picks it up. Players are behind the original kick. That can be the only concern. And even though it's bathed in shadow, I couldn't see a knock on there.
This is unbelievable. Unbelievable. Tim Sheens has been saying all week, kick the Benji Marshall at your peril. They didn't kick him on this occasion, but he's come up with a rolling ball, a double kick, a regather, a right foot step, a left foot step, a shrug, a palm off, a pass, and 6 points. All off this brilliant young man, Benji Marshall to put the Tigers back in it. You said Tim Sheens wanted them in the dressing room. I bet he's glad they stayed out there for another minute now, as they've got back in the game. You can't win it from the dressing room. You've got to be on the field, Rabbitohs. That's the only place you score points.
Thank you, Scoop. Thank you, Scoop Gould. Enough. It's a try. You were very positive. It will be 20, or should I say 18-6, when we do go to the break and Sheens gets a chance to have a chat to them.
And should have been 24-0. We've had a 12-point turnaround as Benji Marshall races away. I've got to point out the effort again of the number 16 to get back there, Luke Stewart. It was all to no avail, but gee, it was an effort. And Daniel Fitzhenry, who I was critical of moments ago, not being in a position, that time he's run a long way to give support to Benji Marshall.
So Marshall with 4 from 6 last week against the Sharks, right in front of the Southern Uprights, and raises the flags. A try that he made possible for Fitzhenry. And takes them to half-time, trailing by 12. We're back with more of Nine Sunday Football in just a moment. South Sydney on their way back. Second half, soon to get underway. 18-6. Three tries. Sutton at the 14th, Jeremy Smith at the 20th, and Yaleen Gordon at the 29th minute. And then right on half time, Fitzhenry was able to finish off a fortuitous piece of work by Benji Marshall. So the Tigers, who could have been down by 24-0 because of a disallowed try to Nigel Vangana, they went to the break at 18-6 down. Of this match will, for the time being, drop out of the eight. And then it's a matter of whether South Tigers or Brisbane, just a matter of who works it out the best to find themselves in the eight. Leichhardt Oval, full to capacity. Ground record of about 22,750 set by these two back in 2005. Tony Archer blowing time on. So the second half is underway. And as I said, at the top of the telecast, to win is a mighty step towards making the top eight. Play just inside the 20-metre line then, after Mellor had returned the kick-off, and Greenfield has left it behind him.
Yeah, some combined defence there, strong stuff. Bronson Harrison, Todd Payton both involved. In fact, it was the second effort coming in from Bronson Harrison after the initial contact. And the crowd, they are straight back into the game after 40 seconds with this opportunity to their team.
Still no Robbie Farah. Marshall going to Lawrence, and Lawrence gets it inside the 10-metre line. Met there by the South Sydney defence of Vangana and Smith. And so the Tigers, with Fatawira taking it towards the centre of the ground. And then from John Morris to Benji Marshall. He shows it twice. He goes wide out for Tio. Tio's over the line. Can he get it down? I don't think so.
Third tackle, that is.
By Tony Archer.
And that's Benji Marshall at his best. Drifting across, dummy, dummy. Then picking up the outside runner, and Ben Teo, but the defence gets there in numbers. We come back, third tackle, 10 metres out. Tigers still with the pressure on.
Marshall again. Payton. Payton. Looking as though he's going to pass it a couple of times. Eventually put down by Smith. Now for Morris to go to Marshall. It'll kick off the outside edge. Rabbitohs ball. Played by Greenfield, who coughed up possession in the first place. And there's South being driven back. Talanoa on the end of the tackle. Vangana taking it out to the 10-metre line now. overshadowed in the tackle by Lawrence. Mellor losing his footing. Todd Payton making the tackle. And this is Rigon out from dummy half. And put down about 22 metres out. So Rigon and Isaac Luke on the park at the same time for Jason Taylor. As Jeremy Smith gets a monster torpedo punt away down the ground. For Hudson to carry it back towards the 40-metre line and then crabbing before he tries to straighten over nearly on the eastern touchline. Where he finds Daniel Fitzhenry. And Fitzhenry brings it up towards halfway. 18-6 at half-time in favour of the South Sydney Rabbitohs. They went out to 18-0. They could have been a 24-0. And then a try near half-time, or right on half-time, saw West Tigers come back into it. It's Ben Galea. He's tackled 35 metres away from the South Sydney line. Morris then for Payton. Payton on to Lawrence. Lawrence on to Fatawira. Fatawira puts his foot down and gets to the 10-metre line on tackle 5. Tackle by Vangana, fellow Kiwi, as it goes to Marshall. He kicks across the ground. It's come off the back of Teo. It's picked up by the Rabbits. And he's going to order a turnover and bring it out towards the 10-metre line.
It was a wonky old kick, wasn't it? I don't know whether he struck it that way on purpose or it just bobbled up in the air and everyone had a play on it. In the end, the Tigers knocked it on. But look at this defence. They've started this second half on fire after a crushing blow landed only 20 seconds before the half-time break.
And there's a surge from Luke Stewart. He's 25 metres away from his own line. The Rabbitohs then getting it just outside the 30. And that is Talanoa again playing the ball. And here is Cusack with a strong carry. Up towards halfway. Play by Peter Cusack. And then Luke a dummy half to a running Greenfield. And a one-hander finds Harrison. In support, but in support for another team. Shadows lengthening across Leichhardt, which becomes a bit of a television nightmare. But this suburban ground reminding us of how good it really was. The boutique rugby league ground, full to capacity on a sunny Sunday in the Harbour City. 30 metres out from the Rabbitohs line for Morris to go to Marshall. And Marshall, Rigon having no part of the fancy dancing. Neither Cusack. And Marshall plays it back to Morris. Then for Hodgson, up at first receiver, shape to go in, went out to Teo. Teo almost through and begging for support, begging for a runner. Then John Morris, a little kick, it's come ricocheting off the feet of the Rabbits. It's Isaac Luke who's running it away. He's come down outside the 40. He gets it away to Dean Winters, goes to ground, gets up, tackled on halfway.
I think they're glad they didn't go and score off that. It might have come back for a video referee. And South Sydney would have lost possession. I honestly think both players played at it and the man in front took the ball away. We'll come back to it.
Talanoa with a run down towards the 30-metre line. Tigers end of the ground as Jeremy Smith unloads to Rigon. He gives it back and the Tigers are with it. Fatawira will play the ball. Held down by Mellor. Payton and Tuaki. Back with strength and running into Cusack. 6 minutes of the second half gone. South Sydney 18-6. And Morris back for Hyington up the middle. And Andrew Voss sideline.
Quick update on the injuries. First of all, Ray Nathan Merritt won't be back because of that knee problem suffered in the opening minutes. Todd Payton's lost the ball here. It'll be a South Sydney scrum feed. On the Tigers front, now Robbie Farah's still in the playing gear. I had a good chat with the Tigers doctor, Dr. Kwan. Now, he did say it's exactly what happened to Checker Langlands in 75. It is probably, in all probability, a reaction to the needle. He's confident the injury is no worse to the hip of Robbie Farah. So it's sort of a good news, bad news story for Robbie Farah. With me, former Rabbitohs captain Mario Fenwick has joined me on the sideline. What a magic day it's been so far.
Oh, it's been magical to come back to Leichhardt and to see the team play so well. But there's a lot to do. This is the game. It's a Cinderella story for us.
Well, beautifully put, Mario. What about you in the halftime? 8 minutes before the break, Nigel Vangana going over to score. Look, the bloke has scored 136 tries in his career. Look at you go off.
that'll probably come back and haunt us. He's dropped the ball over the line, no one around him, and let's hope he doesn't haunt us.
It's been a pleasure to speak to you, Mario. Enjoy the rest of the match.
Go the Bunnies.
Play by Greenfield, and Cusack putting a swerve into his work, and it carries him 25 metres away from the Tigers' line. Here's Luke probing menacingly, and the Tigers shut down the hole that Isaac was looking at. They're 12 metres out from the line now as it comes off the hands of Williams to Smith, and Smith inside for Stewart, and Stewart is put down. 7 metres out from the line, up on the grandstand end of the ground, on the southern end. And now it's gone away for Williams. A little kick into the in goal. And he should get a dividend from this. Line drop out as we take a break and come back in just a moment. Jimmy Williams with that little outside edge. Getting a line drop out return of it. Big crowd enjoying every moment of this. Souths probably on the edge of victory with another try. Big line dropout.
Well, that's the difference we've seen in this second half so far. They had 3 shots at the other end of West Tigers. Poor last tackle play. South Sydney won and they forced a repeat set. So 15 love their way.
Talanoa crossing the 30-metre line. Happy to take them on without looking to unload the ball as they set up for a play down the avenue. It's away for Rogers on the left, and he couldn't get his arms free to give it to Williams. 10 metres out from the Tigers' line. Widders out to first receiver Smith, and then on to Big Stewart. Stewart burst his way between the defenders. And now from Luke again to Williams. Is it now? Yes, it is now. There is Dean Widders over to score the 4th try of the day for the Rabbitohs. No dropping at this time.
And simple. Good stuff. Phil Gould pointed out earlier, they look dangerous with the football. They're going to the line. They're running into spaces. And the passes are being delivered at the right time in the right area. Dean Widders, he's made a couple of long busts. He doesn't travel far for this one. But Joe Williams going to the line. Going to the line. And by going to Collis, he committed him. And by going to the line, he made the outside defender for the West Tigers stay out and not come in to close up a hole for Dean Widders, who Jason Taylor now believes is best served in his side coming off the bench.
Joey Williams set up an identical try against the Manly Sea Eagles on Monday night from close range. And that's the ball-playing talent that was recognised him at a very young age. Robbie Farah, head in the hands as Atazi returns back, struts back, a stride of confidence. So too Dean Widders. But the ball by Joey Williams was outstanding. The way he held the defence up was a little bit like Cliffy Lyons used to do. Cliffy Lyons, as a ball player, used to say, all I want is for the defence to stand still and watch me. Then someone hits the hole at speed. Steve Menzies was his man. Today, Widders scores off Williams.
And talking of Williams, he shoots for conversion again. And again, he's successful. Joey Williams sends them out to 24-6 after 51 minutes. And Andrew.
And Rabs, I can reveal exclusively over in the hotel room that Russell Crowe is watching this afternoon's match on the web. He's been joined by Robert Redford, Burt Reynolds, Matt Damon, Julia Roberts. They've all come in saying, what's going on, Rusty? He's just said they're headed for the finals. The Bunnies, they said, you beauty. They're watching the match now too.
They've all hit the minibar too. They don't care. Spare the expense.
Always wanted to talk to Julia Roberts. 15 metres out from the Rabbitohs line. And Rigon getting it away to Paul Mellor.
What did you say? You've always wanted to talk to Julia Roberts. Yeah. What, do you want an invite to the party now?
There's no harm in trying, Gus.
Where would you rather be, there or here, please?
Probably here.
Exactly.
Here's Asatasi on the 30-metre line. The Rabbitohs out to 24-6. And here is Sutton again. Three-stepping his way. He's been so good, John Sutton. Injured early in the year, as I said, as on the plane coming back. Here's Williams into a gap. Williams has got support. It's Asatasi, front row forward, in support, scoring another South Sydney try. Oh, this is great for Jason Taylor and for South Sydney. Suddenly they know how to score points.
Oh, what an afternoon. And the South Sydney fans, they are outnumbered here, but they are in voice. Roy Asatasi scored a few tries this season, but Joe Williams again setting up through the dummy, sliced through. When we have a look at the replay, he will have a choice of 4 to 5 support players to choose from. But again, the important thing, going to the line, the ball out in front, anything could happen. The one thing they didn't expect with Daniel Fitzhenry, only eyes for his outside man, was for him to throw the dummy. He's got Asatasi here, he's got Ben Rogers, he had support on the other side, a little bit of a juggle there from Asatasi as he looks around. Rogers cries out in joy as Asatasi gets down next to the post. Look at the green and red jerseys around here.
That's wonderful play. He's taunted them with his ball playing, and now with the show and go, he has torn them to shreds. Asatasi nearly put it down, the big boy. Got it on his hip, held onto it, and put it down. Williams for 30.
So Williams keeping up this perfect record. 30-6, the red and green are leading.
Stream of supporters starting to look for exit gates here. That might be premature in the modern game. 30-6, it probably once upon a time sounded massive, but I've seen teams come back. Doesn't look like it's going to happen today, I know that, but it's not impossible. There's a lot of time left. Play by Sutton, Peter.
Just a thin line, isn't it, Ray? They came out all fired up, West Tigers. Ben Teo got held up over the line. If he scores there and it's converted, all of a sudden 18-12 and the momentum swings. But the first time South Sydney got to the other end, they ran in a try and they've kept it going. Rigon out of dummy half. He's come on for Luke, who was tremendous out there again in a cameo.
So Williams a dummy half, then away to Smith, and then on to Sutton, and Sutton's kick comes off the rump of a West Tiger. Back for Jeremy Smith, a wonderful juggle. Asatasi, he does it again. Roy Asatasi, did he get it down? Even if he didn't, it was magnificent.
We're going to go back, I think, have a look and see whether the first touch from Jeremy Smith knocked it on to a opposition player. The ball went up after John Sutton kicked it into the opposition. We're also going to have a look at the put down for Asatasi. Pretty sure he's got a double this year in a match throughout the season. The kick goes up. Let's just have a look at Jeremy Smith when he contests this football. Bang. And it goes into the defence line. And Jeremy Smith will appear and be very hungry to get it. He knocks it forward. The fact that it's gone on and touched the hand of John Morris, does that constitute a knock on?
I don't think so.
No, I think there was an equal contest there. I think it'll be okay.
The big thing about it was the challenge from Smith, just how he attacked the ball. He was going quicker. Now he'll knock it from his grasp to get possession himself, and Morris will come again to touch it. Now, technically that constitutes a knock-on, but I think common sense should prevail here that the ball wasn't propelled into an opposition player. It was propelled forward, and then an opposition player made a play at it. Now, technically, I think there's a difference to allow common sense to prevail, to allow Smith to then go on with this ball. If he knocked it into an opposition player, that's a technical knock-on. He's knocked it forward to regather it, and then the opposition player has made a play for it from behind.
Well, are we
technical knock on, but common sense should prevail and it should be awarded a try.
Well, I agree certainly with the second part there, Gus. I'm just wondering whether they're concerned about the very first touch where they come into it together as to whether they think Smith might have touched it first. I thought it was simultaneous, which means play on.
I don't think the first one's all that bad. I mean, they both challenged for it. To me, it's a try. Common sense, please.
To me, I got the impression it's knocked backwards anyway, but he said no try scrum.
Oh.
Who is it? Tim Mander today.
Well, that's what they're saying. The ruling is the Jeremy Smith that he's put it into an opposition player, and that's the knock on.
Now, totally disagree. I know what the rule is they're trying to apply, but that's a very broad application of the rule to say that that's a knock-on. It's totally different because both players were playing at it. I totally disagree. Wouldn't be the first time, would it?
So the Tigers with another let off. If you add that to the Vangana disallowed try, there's 12 points there for South Sydney. This is Galea. And points are vital, aren't they, Pete?
They are indeed. South Sydney went into this game minus two differential. West Tigers plus seven. So that put them nine behind at the start of this game. They are now 39 ahead. We're trying to fit three into two for next week, the top eight. And it could be differential once again, and it's certainly being helped here with South Sydney's performance in racking up the scoreline.
Hodgson it was who played the ball. Morris comes across, puts a little kick in. There was a Tiger held back. Tiger held back. The touch he's gone in to say to the referee what I'm saying to you.
Paddy. Wait here. Nah.
Chasing the kick, was he?
Thank you. Yeah. Penalty here, taken out, Roy.
It'll be a penalty here to the Tigers. There it is there. Fulton it was, in pursuit of the kick. Yes, Gus, to answer your question. And held back. And the penalty goes to West Tigers. 15 out from the goal mouth. And tapped by Morris. And they send Bronson Harrison in towards Shane Rigon. And they're saying there's a knock on here. And there is. An appeal went out from Folongo. He was lying on the tackle player, Harrison. And you see the Tony Archer, hey, he's knocked on. And Archer had no idea that he'd knocked on. And on closer inspection, he agreed with the appeal from Folongo. And there it was for everybody to see. I think Archer was back checking his 10. Or checking the try line in this case.
Well, they're just a reliable conveyance these days, South Sydney, aren't they? The number of times they've made errors in their own 20 themselves, and you think, oh, well, here comes points. But they repel the opposition. They come up with a way to keep tackling. The only try against them was a freakish effort from the other end of the field with knockdowns and grubber kicks and regathers.
Rugby League's one community this week, and it is Young Care. And there's the www.youngcare.com.au. You can go to that to be of assistance, a greatly appreciated assistance. And here is Stewart. He's been strong. He did something earlier in a chase on the try for Fitzhenry that was just unbelievable and unexpected of a front row forward. It reminded me a little bit of Adam Woolnough on Friday night in a vain chase, but it was still a great play. And now here's Marshall coming back, bunny hopping up towards the 30-metre line, but the bunny's having no part of it. This is...
They should be able to read a bunny hop, shouldn't they?
Well, you'd think so. You would think so. Collis it was who played it. Morris showed it to Gillier, gave it to Safi. And Safi has got the ball 5 metres on South Sydney side of halfway. And a queue, a procession heading for the exit gates. Still, as we watch Fulton, 31 metres out from the South Sydney line. Hodgson, a dummy, then goes off his left foot and runs back to the middle of the ground. Shoots the pass away and it's out there for Tio. Tio looks to unload. He does that. Hodgson is there. The kick is there. The chase is not there. And it's now with Talaneo. And he's put a fend on his own 10. And then he stands in another, waits for the tackle to come over the top from Tio. And Talaneo goes to ground. That line behind him is the 10, and he fell awkwardly, and he's coming away limping, Talaneo. Andrew Voss, sideline.
Yeah, just an update, further news on Robbie Farah. Given the scoreline blowing out to 30 points to 6, I think it's safe to say Robbie Farah's not going to come back on. It will take some sort of miracle right now. And they've only got the shortened week to get him right for Friday night. Tigers against the Knights in Friday night football.
Play back towards halfway. Talanoa, not Talaneo. I don't know where I got that from, but anyway. It won't be the last time. I guess I'll be meeting up with Mr. Moy Moy again one day in the next few weeks. As the kick goes high off the boot of the 7, it's Jeremy Smith, and it goes down to Marshall. And here's Marshall again, outside the 20.
Next Sunday, Raps. Fooey Fooey up against the Brisbane Broncos in our Sunday game. That'll be important as well.
So 17 from 27 for the Tigers, completions, and 23 from 34 for South. Hodgson, ball going across to Tuaki. Tuaki, hard down the left touchline. Oh, he put a fend on Smith. He said, get away, get out of here. I'm heading for the in goal. And Tuaki scores for the West Tigers.
Well, Jeremy Smith will have a handprint on his chest for the next 2 weeks. It was almost an intercept taken by South City. In fact, the referee signaled six again. He'll be touched here by that South player, but Tuaki is a tough man to tackle. Jeremy Smith just got in a position where Tuaki could get a real forceful push on him. And takes it round to get their second of the afternoon. They'll be on 12 in a moment.
You say you have a handprint on his chest for the next 2 weeks. He'll have that handprint on his heart for the next 30 years. He will never forget the day that Tuaki pushed him off like that.
Benji Marshall converting the Tuaki try. It's 30-12, 61 minutes down in Sunday football.
The try scorer, Tuaki, has been mixing his game between playing on the wing and in the back row. And a try that momentarily stopped that file of people looking for an exit gate. Another one now, they might start to retrace their steps. Here's Safi.
I'd say, Ray, look, it might sound a little bit ridiculous. It's a big lead, 30-12, but there's still a quarter of this game to go. And I don't want to keep pointing it out, but last week, West Tigers showed how quickly they can score points. They are one team who can reel in such a deficit if they can get a lot of possession and field position, which they're starting to get a little bit of now.
This young fellow, Tio, looks to me like he's heading somewhere. He's certainly going in a northward direction. The ball is going in the wrong direction over the sideline for the Tigers. But Tio, back to him for a moment. He's a good young player, believe me.
He was a Peter Sterling medal winner out of the Arrival Live Cup a couple of years ago, Benny Teo. Again, they forced their hand down the right-hand short side. It was a pass that, if they had found the mark, would have created an opportunity. Now, look, I agree. You know, 18 minutes left on the clock. When you think about it, they only need to score two tries to take it down to the wire. So whilst we're thinking four tries to win, two tries makes a real game of it. And they've got Golden Point up their sleeve.
Well, I think the Tigers would be happy to go to Golden Point at this
stage. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, but it's just how it can swing. I'd be looking for that field goal if I was the Rabbits.
John Sutton right on halfway. And the ball played back to Talanoa. 5 metres into West Tigers territory. Isaac Luke back with us, and then Stewart. And the tackle from Morris and Galloway. Morris got up a little bit high, but there was nothing in it.
Jeremy Smith did shape for field goal late in the first half. Joe Williams has kicked one this season. We're a bit too far out to take on this occasion, but do keep an eye out for it in the next 5 to 10 minutes.
Nigel Vanganar played the ball, and Sutton puts a kick in that again ricochets. Good for South Sydney. Asatasi's there again. Asatasi, he stands and unloads, keeps it alive. Williams gets it on. Luke tries to get through. Gets the ball back to Dean Winters. He looks for another phase. Gets the ball away. Race for the ball in the corner. South Sydney are jumping. South Sydney jumping for joy. Yaleen Gordon has got another try, we think.
He's kicked the football there, Dean Winters. Knew that it was the last tackle. John Sutton, he's kicked it into the opposition again. He might be starting to do that deliberately. They nearly scored last time he did it through Asatasi. They keep the ball alive. It is still the last tackle. Asatasi shrugs one away. Joe Williams gets it. Isaac Luke, he's back out there. He finds Dean Winters. Now, Dean Winters has claimed you, and I'm sure that he kicks the football. Somehow, he's towed it through. And Yaleen Gordon, from his reaction, believes that he's got his second by touching down just in the field of play.
Well, if the video referee's fair dinkum, he's got about 38 things to look at here. There's a couple of little obstructions. There's a bit of a hold back. There's a couple of offsides. Does Jeremy Smith hold him back here to stop him from getting the ball? I think it's a try. I don't think he would have got there, but if he wanted to go back through it individually, he can pull it up for any number of things.
Well, the only concern I would have, Gus, and they haven't gone back that far, is when the ball was kicked into the West Tigers player and it landed in the arms of a South Sydney player where he started from.
But well, he was okay, but the three of alongside of him were actually offside. You can pull it up for any number of reasons. They're onside here for the kick. I'm a little bit worried by this hand. I think they're working out whether or not the ball hits the ground before he kicks it. No, he's kicked it. That's okay. Jeremy Smith comes around. They're both onside. Jeremy Smith has a grab on Fitzhenry. That's not allowed, but I don't think he would have got there anyway.
You used the word technicality earlier, and a try disallowed for Roy Asatasi, and that's a technicality there. But I think this is going to be green. I thought that last time and was wrong. Yaleen Gordon, no matter what a game. It's a try given by video referee Tim Mander to Yaleen Gordon. 34-12 now, 63 down.
Well, it's a brilliant try. I remember one they scored earlier this year that actually, well, they didn't score. Actually ended up in injuring John Sutton. The ball went across the field two or three times. But this was brilliant. The ability to keep the ball alive. Williams, Isaac Luke, Dean Witters, in and away, Fenn, presence of mind to kick, and Gordon grabs a double. It's brilliant football.
Well, that game you're talking about, Gus, was late in the Brisbane match, and we asked the question why they weren't doing it earlier in the game. Well, they've come here with an attacking attitude. In fact, I think Jason Taylor, with a month to 6 weeks to go, has seen that they needed to improve that area, and he's tweaked this side around. He moved Nathan Merritt to fullback. There was some controversy with David Peachy going back to Premier League, but Nathan Merritt was absolutely outstanding in going there. He's moved the halves around. He's gone back to that man on screen now. Ben Rogers has gone to lock forward. Sutton's come into the back row. All of a sudden, there are more options and more adventure in their ball play.
He's almost gone back to where he was, Peter. I remember on a footy show, a Sunday footy show, I was on it with you, and Jason was in a quandary about this fellow playing seven and Smith playing six. And the kick from Williams is a Bobby Dazzler. Hasn't he had a game, Joey Williams? And what about his kicking? Andrew Voss, sideline.
Outstanding stuff. And another milestone reached for South Sydney this afternoon. This, in fact, is their highest points tally in a match for any time this year. The only time they topped 30 points in a game was exactly 5 months to the day ago, back to round two against Parramatta. So they've shown they can score points. They've shown they can do it 2 weeks out from the playoffs.
Yes, Andrew. 36-12. Talanoa held inside the 30-metre line. Of course, waiting at the end of all of this struggling by West Tigers, by Brisbane, by South Sydney, even by Canterbury, is the unenviable thought that one of them is going to be up against Melbourne at Olympic Park on a Sunday afternoon in the first weekend of the playoffs.
Not even thinking about that, Ray. It's a new competition. First has never been beaten by eight. But every team goes into the finals thinking they're capable of winning by the very fact that they're there, as Rogers hits the ball high.
Oh, it's in the sun, and Hobson did well. Teammates actually looked up and turned away, and I thought, oh gee, there's going to be a bounce here for South Sydney, but Hodgson flew into the act and clutched it down for the Tigers. This is Big Galloway, 24-point ball game now, 36-12 in favour of South Sydney. A dominating performance, a colourful performance, one that they've worked hard to achieve, to make the top eight. And they haven't made it yet, but they're nearly there for the first time since 1989.
Great inside cover there from Asatasi on Safi as West Tigers replying kind of the high kick put over the sideline by Talanoa. Will be a West feed here. But Asatasi, beautiful in cover defence. Used to wrap Glenn Lazarus. The amount of ground he covered on the inside to clean up. Asatasi doing the same.
Rabbits wrote in the Sun Herald this morning, the battle for coach of the year. For mine, while there are plenty of contenders, probably comes down to the competition leader, Craig Bellamy, whose team was expected to win this competition. Yet, despite all that, he's still got them in number one place ready to strike. And this fellow, Jason Taylor, who has taken over a team running last and now on the verge of finals football.
As it goes along the back line, Hodgson finding Collis. Robbie Farrow virtually taking no part in this game, and a penalty goes to West Tigers. Rogers penalised. He was called held and he went back in on top of him with a hand. And Galloway is a couple of metres out from the line. Jason Taylor for Coach of the Year. Who would argue with that? Morris goes back for Marshall. Marshall short for Fulton it is. And the ball has come out. So this is to be expected now, obviously. But they didn't control possession all that brilliantly when it probably wasn't the factor that it is now.
All right, coming into round 24, we have a look at the mistake there. Last year, South Sydney had won three games. They were last on the ladder and they conceded 686 points.
Yeah.
Now, coming into this round 24, they'd won 11. They were eighth on the ladder and they conceded 361. Yeah. 686 to 361. There's your improvement and there's how you become competitive in the NRL.
Having said all that, one has to say, and there's Jason on camera, he was given a shot at this by Russell and Peter Holmes at court with some very good talent, attracted by the new management and the cattle that they've provided him with. Blokes like this fellow, Widders, and Vanganar and Asatasi. Is it any wonder that they've improved quite considerably? But what you're talking about are dramatic figures.
No, well, the cattle helps, there's no doubt about that. His last tackle now, Joe Williams drives it in.
Yeah, Hodgson back outside his 10, and Brett coming away. I'm just thinking about Robbie Farrow. Downhearted, obviously. He's made the point a couple of times. He doesn't want to go out wandering this season. He wanted to play, injured or not injured. They needled him, but we're led to believe that that has gone wrong, and it's been really a Channel England's 1975 revisited situation with Robbie Farrow today, if we're getting the story correctly. Morris back for Hyington, and Hyington towards halfway is put down. There's Robbie Farrow, dejected. It's not over yet for the Tigers, one has to say that, but as I kept on saying earlier in the day, to win this was a giant step.
The problem there, Rabbits, is do they needle him again next week? Do they take the risk or make him play with the pain? Because if they needle him again and he gets numb leg again, it's their last game if they lose.
Here's Hodgson. Yeah, well, I don't know enough about it to have a comment even, except this ball has found Collis and he puts it on the toe, and Talanoa did well. Now, they seem to think that he might have had a knock on in it, but no. Referee said no.
He was in very good position to again call on that one. He's a good afternoon for Tony Archer.
Oh, he's right up there with a chance of the grand final whistle. Make no mistake about that. He is right up there, Tony Archer. 150th game today. 30 metres out from the line. South Sydney's Paul Mellor just nonchalantly walks back to his position.
We made the comment after 20 minutes that South Sydney had effectively beat off the influence of the crowd so far as they was concerned. And the crowd can only now influence one man, which was the referee. Well, they haven't. He's been very, very strong in front of a parochial crowd. Refereed an entirely fair game. He's had some tough decisions. We don't agree with all of them, but at least he's had the guts to make them. And I agree, it's been a great performance by the referee.
Greenfield knocking on for the Rabbits. Yeah, well, the decisions that you've been arguing about, and I guess we have in chorus, haven't been his calls.
Been upstairs.
No, been upstairs.
The crowd today, right? Over 20,000, 20,232. You pointed out that the record for the West Tigers here at Leichhardt, 22,877. Speaking to Steve Noyce before this game, they didn't allow any more in than 20,232. And when you have a look around, well, not now because plenty have left, but at kickoff, they would have struggled to have found a place to put an extra 10 people.
Been a wonderful success story, and I congratulate West Tigers on playing the game here and resisting the temptation of many, many thousands of dollars up at Telstra. They thought it would work for them, the home ground advantage, but that hasn't been a factor as far as South were concerned. As far as they're concerned, they're playing at Redfern. The soil is pretty much the same as Hodgson.
slips through, gets it away to Fulton. Fulton gets it on. That is Lawrence. Did he ground the ball? Archie will ask Mander to have a look at it.
He fell awkwardly. He fell awkwardly as he tried to drag it down. He's saying that perhaps he got it down before the ball came loose. He comes down before the line. Now he'll try to get his elbow back to get it on the ground. There, and it falls out. Great tackle.
Wonderful tackle by Nigel Vunganar.
Gee, it's hard to score tries. Nigel Vunganar has got one back. He dropped one earlier today over the line, unattended. But he has waited until the 72nd minute to get it back for his team. Wonderful defence.
And has denied another real try scorer in Chris Lawrence. This 16th of the season. Comfortably their leading try scorer. I'll be having a look to see if the ball scraped the ground just after getting over the line. There.
No.
But his reaction, Chris Lawrence, that even cries out that he believes that he's lost it. Looking at it, grounding the football. No.
You can't give it. Your dead set can't give it.
So here's the Tim Mander decision. It's a 20-metre restart. So as far as Nigel's concerned, Vunganar, that is probably 15 all for him now. But I heard somebody suggesting that maybe if you run over the stripe, that should be sufficient for a four-pointer in rugby league, as in gridiron. But that's an example of defence at its best from Nigel.
Leave us out of that. And I've got to say, Nigel Vunganar, he's won in straight sets here, Rabs. He's through to the next round comfortably.
You talk about Jeremy Smith wearing that fen from Tuaki on his heart for a long time to come. And Nigel remembering that try too for some time to come. But it's not going to be probably so painful now.
Zero! Zero!
And Rabbits, news coming through from up at Suncorp Stadium that the Broncos have defeated the Raiders today. It was touch and go for a long time. At one time, the Raiders led 13 points to 6. But in the end, Broncos too strong, 30 to 19. Now with their four and against, they will join the Tigers on 24 points and, in fact, go in front of them. So now with this loss, the Tigers, I believe, are outside the eight with one round to go, and the Broncos are in. Broncos play Parramatta. Broncos play Parramatta next week at Parramatta Stadium.
Yep, television game.
And the Tigers will take on the Knights,
which you'll see on Friday night. South Sydney, we're up against the Roosters, but next Friday night, as we pointed out earlier, the Cowboys, who will finish top four up against the Dogs, chasing top four. And also, the Tigers up against the Knights.
South Sydney. Go to the 10-metre line. 7-6, the penalties in favour of South Sydney. Luke to Asatasi, who's been so strong today. So good today. Roy Asatasi. Luke then for Williams. Wide it goes to Talanoa. He's got a job done in the face of the disappointment for Nathan Merritt. Injured in the early minutes of the game. Souths have done it without him. And Talanoa had to suddenly become the stand-in fullback. Played by Rogers now. 10 metres out, played slowly as it comes to Williams, to Greenfield. He's always looking to unload, this young fellow in 17. Always looking for support. And Williams for drop goal now. Williams likes it. Archer looking, puts the arm up. And there's the one pointer. 37 plays 12.
Well, we thought one would come. Will be later than expected. He gets his second of the season, Joe Williams. That's the full stop at the end of the sentence.
Should we vote for man of the match now? Can we give it to him? Is it fait accompli?
I think he's hard to beat.
He'll be hard to beat, I think.
Kicking off. Andrew Voss sideline.
Well, look, South Sydney have this one all wrapped up. They have to prepare for next Saturday now against arch rivals, the Roosters. I just wonder, look, I don't wish any bad news for Nathan Merritt, but if the injury is enough to keep him out, you know, we may be talking, Mario said, Cinderella story earlier this afternoon. What about David Peachey coming back to first grade for the final round and into the final series? Lots of players over the last few seasons have had destiny as Tigers get an intercept, but destiny to end his career, David Peachey, finals footy.
That was Chris Hyington trying to get a hand on the ball and pick up another try. Able to hang on to it. Did well, Hyington. And now it's away for Galea. Galea back to Hodgson. Hodgson taken down by Rogers. Yeah, that is Cinderella and Goldilocks and all the others wrapped into one, isn't it? Galloway, David Peachy.
He looked silky smooth in their win here today for North Premier League side. He looked a class above the opposition. And he would relish that opportunity as John Morris fires it to Benji Marshall. Got support. And how he got it to Hyington.
Hyington gives the impression he's trying to keep that good try-scoring record against the Rabbits up. Marshall short for Fulton.
It went forward.
Forward pass. It's a scrum. It was the fourth tackle.
His previous pass to Hyington, I think, was a no-look pass. Something out of his touch football kit bag. And this one, he just didn't turn the body around enough. He looked inside, didn't get his body back. Fulton rushed him. And the ball goes forward out of his hands. Sometimes the ball runner is the one who forces that because he arrives so early. The man with the ball's got to pass quickly. Doesn't get a chance to turn back on it. What a day. What a great day.
Bungana wrapped up in front of his own goal. Jeremy Smith, dummy half, and Greenfield. Michael Greenfield. I talked about Tio. Greenfield is another youngster heading in the right direction, no doubt. Rogers is with it. In this reshuffle that Jason Taylor has come up with, Rogers has gone from 6 to 13. Jeremy Smith and Williams back as his halves. And here's Folongo. Tackled 15 short of halfway. Smith unloading, then Cusack, back for Smith, back for Cusack. The Smith and Cusack show, intercepted and spoiled by Marshall, who shrugs one away. Beats another, circles another, runs into Smith. And Jeremy with a broad smile on his face, as has Benji. Now Morris to Fulton, who shows it to Lawrence, but then he's heading for the ground on his back. Thumped down by Sutton and Smith. Morris for Payton. Payton taken by Cusack and Folongo. Just on the south side of halfway. 37 to 12. A couple of minutes to go in the game as Hodgson goes across to Collis, and Collis trying to break through, and then he would go back to Hodgson on his inside. A problem there for Todd Payton. As Hodgson puts in a kick, rebound off a South player who didn't plant the ball. And the 17 is Ben Galea. The tackle count continues out to 5. And play by Ben Galea. Collis' pass, indicative of the tiredness in the ranks of the West Tigers. Knock on Galloway. Knock on by Galloway. On the final, it should be changeover.
Well, the big story for the Tigers here today, obviously, is Robbie Farah. He's starting to take on Andrew Johns, Darren Lockyer type importance to this Tigers team. When he's not out there, they really do look like a rabble. He's instrumental in so much of the play that him missing from the ranks, they just haven't been together today. Take nothing away from the Rabbitohs. Outstanding. Their defence was outstanding. And they threw in some tries for good measure.
Sydney's Talanoa with one of the final play the balls in the game. We're coming up to just 1 minute to go.
Going to run again from Asatasi, leading this side well. Manikafara also available to come back for South Sydney as Joe Williams drives it down. And a lovely kick there from our man of the match this afternoon, the Brute Impact man of the match, Joe Williams. 6 goals and a field goal. Plenty of good kicks in general play, but most importantly, he was the puppeteer all afternoon. Threw the last pass or the crucial pass in so many tries, just played with composure this afternoon. Just the game that Jason Taylor was looking for. And he really has been a class player out there this afternoon in a game that came with plenty of pressure attached.
Yeah, a young man that took one on the chin during the year. Sent back to have a look at park football by Jason Taylor, then recalled, and he's turned out to be the hero of the day in one of the most anticipated club games in the last decade. Greenfield taken to ground inside the 20.
There's the siren. It is over at Leichhardt in front of 20,000 people. 37 points to 12. The Rabbits over the Tigers.